Hello again, I'm Ahmed Fauzi, and welcome to our program on music and peace with Honey Kalaria, founder of Honey's Dance Academy. And also, we will be welcoming later Zwai Bala, a singer-songwriter from South Africa. Music has always been a big part of Peace Day celebrations. Peace One Day has been producing concerts, as you know, since 2002. First, let's take a look at and listen to and enjoy three songs that were created in support of Peace One Day. And they helped massively in raising awareness of Peace Day. Let's run those apparently beautiful songs, guys, please. Songs, thank you.
Africa, say yeah! Let's go!
So many broken hearts. Tell me when will it mend? And it's a trend that we gotta break. If we could stop being fake, yeah. Look at where we're going, look at what is at stake. Examine the cause, examine the effect. When there is no justice, tell me what do you expect? Let's genuflect and show respect to every class, color, and creed, and let's keep in check. Don't get entangled in the selfish wreck. Look what you give is what you get, and we could get peace.
Killings on the news, and Africa getting a bad review. Them keys dropping out of school, bombs everywhere in class, and there's nothing they can do. I seen a baby lose a whole family, funeral service singing a slow medley. Yeah, but me, I can't afford to lose another, 'cause you my brother, type of blood from a different mother. Yeah,
you're Nigeria, I'm Tanzania.
Oh yeah,
break the barriers. Finding Africa,
not divided by segregation, and we're not shaken by definition. No.
Beautiful sunsets that take your breath away, our freedom to dream, no one can take away. Still waiting for someone to come take the pain away, while they tell our history that way.
Oh. One voice, one spirit, united. One voice, one spirit, united.
Eu vivo neste mundo de guerra, eu sou desta terra. Vejo tanta violência, convivo com carência. Eu quero dar o amor, eu quero ter valor, ajudar o meu país, já eu quero ser feliz. Tanto ódio que assusta, viver assim não custa. Vamos todos em busca, juntos vencemos a luta. Pra que essa disputa? Pra que essa força bruta? Surge, tambula, todos Moçambique, força!
You are good to me, is the truth in me. We can unity, every nation, yeah.
Take this journey like religion, and I am walking it to perfection.
That's right.
Beautiful night stars that guide you all the way. In spite of the obstacles that can get in your way. Keep believing, I'm hearing what I say.
One voice, one spirit,
every color.
To lose another, cause you my brother, tell my blood from a different mother.
One day, we will sense already do something we will see. One day, you know, here with something we will hear.
That's it. Music is just energizing, isn't it? And this is the segment on music and peace. And it's a great pleasure to have with us Dr. Hani Kalaria. And Hani is the founder of Hani's Dance Academy, and known as the Bollywood Ambassador to the UK. Hani, welcome.
Thank you very much.
It's a great pleasure to see you and to have you here. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Ahmed.
Could you tell us about yourself and your dance academy and your connection with Bollywood?
Of course. Well, I started dancing from the age of 4. And when I won my first prize, when I was on stage as a little child, this passion in dance just grew. And by the time I was 13 years old, I was performing on stage professionally. And by the time I was 16 years old, I was training Bollywood stars and, you know, choreographing concerts in Bollywood. After then, I graduated, I did my master's in public relations, and I set up an academy called Hani's Dance Academy in 1997. In this country. It was the first academy in this country. And my work was to educate people about what Bollywood was and how beautiful it was, because I had such passion for dance. And since then, of course, I had a great chance to work with, you know, members of the community, some of them just learning dance, some of them developing careers, some of them taking part in shows and TV, films, etc. And my projects also, of course, included things like launching a Bollywood workout video. It could have been, you know, working with Bollywood production companies, coordinating artists and promoting locations in the UK. Right through to, you know, breaking the Guinness Book of Records and all sorts of things. And recently, of course, it was honorary. I got an honorary Doctorate of Arts from East London, University of East London. And that was also to promote Bollywood in the country. So I've been really, really privileged to have such great opportunities and to be able to really use my hobby, which is dance, to be out there, connect with the community and perhaps make a little difference.
That's fascinating. Thank you for sharing that. Yeah, I'm tempted to ask you what record you broke in the Guinness Book of Records.
Oh yes, that was very interesting. The project was, it was a Sky TV show, and we got the largest number of studio audience members to perform a dance in the shortest time possible. And there were all these invigilators just checking if they all got their moves right. It was fantastic. It was a great opportunity.
So what does all this have to do with peace? Honey, can you tell me, does dance play a role in a more peaceful world?
Well, dance, I believe, has a very strong spiritual connection, because dance is a creative force. Dance, if you look at primitive areas and that arena, you will find that groups and collective groups would come together to celebrate religious festivals, rituals. They would even dance to get the rain coming, or connecting with Mother Earth, for example. So primitive methods of dance, there was always this spiritual connection to Mother Earth and to the universe. And later on, you find that as they developed the spiritual connection, you found that nowadays, because there's no age, no limits, no, you don't need to be a professional dancer, you don't have to be, you know, you can just be somebody who enjoys dance. You will find that it gives you a very uplifting feeling, like a joyful feeling when you dance. And a joyful feeling, if you look in spiritual terms, has a very high vibration because it's uplifting. So if you find that you're getting joyful when you dance, it brings inner peace because you feel good. And that inner peace always, I believe, starts off from yourself, which can then generate outwards. So collectively, if you get a group of people performing together, dancing together, I believe that creates great unity, good collectivity. And through dance, you can really enjoy. You can really, you know, enjoy the music, enjoy connecting to people, get a sense of belonging. So I believe there's a spiritual connection to dance. And it brings out, it also allows you to express and create. Because if you see any dance performances, if you see people performing, you'll see it's a creative piece of art.
It's contagious.
Oh, definitely. And getting involved with dance for peace, I mean, what better way to get people involved in connecting to their inner self, enjoying an activity that everybody loves?
Do you have a particular example of the inspirational power of dance?
I believe it depends on which perspective we're looking at, the inspiration of power, the power of dance. Because, you know, there are so many areas where dance has a real profound effect in the community. I say that because, for example, many years ago, even now I would say, people from all across the world would use dance for communicating very powerful messages. So, Native Americans, they would have a powerful message of connecting to Mother Earth or spirits of nature. If you look at Middle Eastern dance, you will have this powerful message of a female dancer celebrating their sensuality or childbirth, let's say. And with Indian, let's say Hindu mythology, you have Lord Shiva. And if you look at Nataraj, which is another name, a dancing name for Lord Shiva, he dances, and the message they give that dance is about creating, preserving, and destroying. So it's like a dance, it's a meaningful thing. So for me, this dance has power, this meaning behind it. There's people, if you look at the deep meaning of dance, nowadays, people may think it's just aerobics, it's just movement, it just show a bit of expression, a bit of emotion. But if you look deeply, there is meaning that goes behind it. So nowadays, if we look at modern times, things like the power and the inspiration of dance could be developing talent. Someone could develop a whole career and become a superstar, you know, like a choreographer or a, you know, pop star using the I would say, the art of dance.
Of course. Tell me what Peace Day means to you.
Peace Day for me, I believe it's about communicating to the world that let's follow a religion of humanity. Let's develop more humanitarian values within us. And for me, that means love, peace, and truth, which are three of the most important values I think we need to incorporate within our lives, because it affects all different areas of what we do. And then there's also self-respect and respecting all others, which also, I would say, generates good harmony between people, good friendships. And this friendship could go between individuals, communities, organizations, even nations, or you could say even international policymakers. It's all about, if you develop these humanitarian values, there'll always be a chance to understand the other person's point of view.
Do you think that a day will come when everyone will dance as one?
Well, without people realizing, I think the dance actually comes through them. They don't realize that even moving your feet means there's dance to the rhythm. There's a rhythm that goes on in this universe. There's always this music which we don't realize. The cycles go on, the way we move. But what you're talking about dance, I think our aim should be to not just do peace one day. It should be dance, you know, get everyone in the world dancing for peace one day. So hopefully Jeremy will, you know, perhaps incorporate one of those little initiatives in the future.
Tell us about your observation of Peace Day last year. What did you do and what do you think people got from it?
Okay, last year, unfortunately, I wasn't around, I was away, and I was enjoying a really great spiritual retreat time. So I was relaxing and actually building inner peace, I should say. When you're spiritually growing, you're actually building inner peace, hopefully building your own strength to go out there to do more work. for others, perhaps to do more good for others. But what I did notice when I came back and I read about the kind of work and the impact it had on the world, it was amazing. I read something along the lines of 1.5 billion people were exposed to the messages of peace. Over 700 million people got involved in some shape or form. I mean, that's huge. Can you imagine even a short percentage of those people changing their lives or their outlook or becoming more positive? You know, I mean, that's reminds me of what Gandhi says, you know, be the change that you wish to see in the world. So this really inspires that. So I was really proud to see that. And the other thing I really noticed about last year was, I have to say, big congratulations to the team at Peace One Day, because they're so dedicated. They have this powerful vision, and it's not just a vision, they're manifesting it. They're making something, you know, happen with it. And that's why I would like to really congratulate people like Jeremy and acknowledge people like that, that go and do more good, and hopefully more people will come in and help and support
this
cause.
Thank you, honey. I could talk to you for hours, but I'd like you finally to tell dancers watching you out there how they can get engaged in Peace Day.
I think if you wanted to get involved...
And to participate in the One Day, One Dance campaign.
Absolutely. Well, we're holding a special one-hour session on Sunday where we've invited people of all cultural backgrounds to get involved in Bollywood dancing. And the aim would be, of course, to also exchange messages of peace. But dance is a way to really, really, you know, I would say, enjoy an activity, give out powerful messages, make new friends, get fitter, burn a few calories while you're there, and learn a few groovy moves, and you know, learn about another culture perhaps. If you've never done Bollywood dancing, come and learn Bollywood dance. If you're interested in a hip-hop dance piece one day, go and join that. It doesn't matter. I think it's about getting actively involved. It doesn't matter whether you can dance or you can't dance. It's about being involved. So I would say to everyone out there, just get involved and, you know, make a difference and be an inspiration to others to get involved.
Thank you very much, honey. We'll get involved. We'll learn some groovy moves on Peace Day and beyond. Right now, we're going to listen to Zwai Bala, a music star from South Africa. Zwai.
Hi everyone, my name is Zwai Bala. I'm from South Africa, was born in South Africa, spent a lot of time all over the place, but most of my time here was born into a very musical family. Wasn't very good at school, so music is the one thing I really know what to do well, more than a lot of other things. I was trained as a classical singer, and otherwise I really made my mark, I guess, as a producer, a music producer. I guess fame came to me when I was with my very popular group called TKZ in the late 90s, which took Africa by storm. Maybe some of you might remember me with the dreadlocks in the group, and we used to sing Salama Pansula, Kitama Dota, and others. Since then, I've been working with all sorts of great artists from the continent all over. Worked a bit overseas too. And I'm just writing music and making music with many Africans. Music has incredible power. You know, I always make the example of the you know, when you're watching a movie and there's nothing going on, there's no dialogue, no one is talking, but once there's a piece of music that plays, it kind of gives you a sense of, you know, it puts you into the mood, or it gives you a sense of what's about to happen. And that's what I've really gone into the last few years, just, you know, trying to evoke emotions and use music to, you know, to also tell stories and how you know how you let it out and how you want to portray the message. With regards to the Peace One Day song, for me, I wanted the song to be just around that one, at least, that feeling that everyone can get. And then I started developing the song around that. It's much easier to write music that way when you have something to talk about and there's an emotion that you're trying to portray because you have to feel it first. And I think with that song, I was very happy with you know, just how it came out. And a lot of people tell me it's very easy to sing along to, which was the main point, really. There was so much excitement before the performance of the anthem at Peace Day in Kigali last year. Because we had recorded it, we had done it on Coke Studio in Nairobi already. So the artists were just looking forward to singing it, and it was so lovely. Singing it a few times and people catching on to it. And because it's so nice to sing with other people, that you're not like, you know, we get the butterflies as performers sometimes, like, oh, how's it gonna go down, or you're nervous about the words, or you're nervous about this and that. But that experience was just special because we knew that we, you know, we're doing something that we are together in spiritually, and you know, we're connecting on. This is not about, you know, which star is which star, who's more famous than who, and who's got the bigger screams from the crowd. It was just like, oh man, let's just do this. We're looking forward to doing it. Even when we were traveling in different vehicles to the stadium, you know, we're just like, you know, jamming in the car, just like singing it, you know. And that's the whole idea, that Africans need to own it. And it was a great feeling, even getting back home, even back to the hotel, you know, everyone was having such a good time and everyone was so pleased with their action and their decision in taking part in the campaign and in the movement. So it's an all round feel good feeling. For me, just peace on its own. I think in my own experience, I think a lot of problems that are in the world, a lot of problems that are in society, a lot of problems that are in any form of association, be it a relationship, a friendship, a choir or church gathering, whatever, people, I think, have a problem with themselves and then take out those problems on other people. And the sad part is that a lot of the time, people that have problems with themselves don't know they've got problems with themselves because they're not at peace with themselves. And I think for me, the message is to really just look inside, because if it starts with you, then it should be easier to make peace with the next person. And I think you know, issues such as self-confidence and wanting to shine and FOMO, you know, fear of missing out, you know, it's all good. The more you're at peace with yourself, is the more you'll be relaxed around other people, the less you'll be suffering from peer pressure and so forth. And I think for me, peace is about your own self. Be at peace with what you believe in. Be at peace with what you understand and what you're comfortable with. And be at peace with yourself, generally.
And what would you suggest for people and young people watching? What would be the best way to use and embrace and celebrate Peace Day?
I think don't be scared to reach out your hand to the next person. It's about peace. You know, when it's Mother's Day, we say, Happy Mother's Day to our sister. Happy Mother's Day to, you know, the person that's working in the garden, you know, well, to whoever is around, whatever the status of the person is. But we say Happy Mother's Day to anybody because they are a mother. And I think for Peace Day, it's Peace Day. Let's be peaceful. Let's not raise our voices. Let's hold each other's hand in harmony, together as one, really. And I think that's the one day that you have, you know, and let's use it. And I think it's a beautiful thing when we're together and in harmony. And at least let's just love each other for once.
What an incredible man, Zwai Bala from South Africa. Amazing artist, truly demonstrating the power of music in the world of peace. You can watch the full interview with Zwai on the Peace One Day YouTube channel. Don't forget to comment on this show, on our Facebook page here on this show, and to share with your friends. Comment and share. Watch, comment and share. Thank you all for watching, and thank my guests, Honey and Zwai, for their fantastic contributions. Our next program coming up shortly will be our fourth Peace Talk with Melissa Morbeck. This one is with Melissa Morbeck, and she's the Executive Director of the Corporate Alliance Against Domestic Violence. Very important work they're doing. And as always, don't forget, today is the day to make peace. Today is the day to reach out, to say you're sorry, to say I love you, to make peace. Tell us what you're doing. We'd love to know, so do get in touch via social media. Thank you from all of us for watching, and a big thank you to our guests, Honey and Zwai. That's the end of the segment on music and peace. We have two or three more segments to go. Very, very interesting. Jude Law is coming up. Stay with us.